As Ansel Adam once said, you don't take a photograph, you make it. To be a photographer is to be an artist. I'm Jeffrey Wong, an architectural photographer with a specialty in black and white fine art images. By stripping away layers to reveal the essence of a structure, I transform buildings into art forms. The Canon EOS R5 is the perfect choice for architectural photography. Its compact size and powerful features allows me to take tricky angles effortlessly and discreetly. For lenses, my constant are the RF 15-35mm wide-angle lens, the EF 24-70mm zoom lens, and the TSE 70mm tilt-shift lens for correcting vertical distortions. To attach my EF mount, tilt-shift, and zoom lenses to my EOS R5, I simply use a mount adapter. Everything works flawlessly together. My photos are a reflection of my imagination, and each image is crafted with tiny details. I observe lines and look out for patterns to tell a story. For iconic structures, I try to weave in the building's historical context. The first step to a great photo is location scouting. Exploring unique vantage points give an edge to my photography. I take a walk, searching for an angle that strengthens the lines of the building. In architectural photography, the horizontal and the vertical lines of a building should be kept parallel. Canon tilt-shift lenses remove perspective distortion by shifting the optics to enable the camera to capture parallel instead of converging lines. The TSE 17mm lens has the widest angle of view and is great for shooting in tight spaces. On the other hand, the TSE 24mm is versatile and produces natural-looking images for many types of scenes. Next, study the building. Note how the sunlight travels, where the shadows fall, where the access points are. This helps to create a different perspective. Perspective matters when establishing an atmosphere. To emphasize a building's immense size, I move closer and look up to capture how impressive it is. The EOS R5 wide-angle LCD screen helps me to frame building accurately and anchor the perspective exactly how I want it to be. Every photographer knows that the ideal shot is subjective, but for composition, I have two personal guidelines. First, keep the image simple and uncluttered. Less is more. Second, bring the environment into the picture to give the viewers a feel of the real world. Adding people into the image gives a better sense of scale to the building and breathes life into an otherwise static photo. For shots like this, handheld shooting gives me the most flexibility to quickly frame my shot. With EOS R5 in-body image stabilization of up to 8 stops, my images stay sharp, allowing me to focus on what matters, crafting my shot. In architectural photography, weather creates the mood. Lights shape the building, and texture completes the picture. My routine is to wait for the ideal position of the sun. High contrast lightings reveal hidden patterns and shapes. Sometimes, the ideal spot and composition may be overcast with shadows. When one part of the subject is too brightly lit and another is hidden in dark shadows, I use exposure bracketing. The EOS R5 auto exposure bracketing feature conveniently captures up to 3 stops of different exposure values with one press. In post, I blend them together to get the correctly exposed final image. Lights at different hours of the day exhibit different color temperatures. After the sun sets, the blue hour arrives. It is a short time window to photograph, so arrive early to check the point of view and set up to test shots. The blue hour creates a complementary color palette that dresses up your subject with a powerful visual effect. This time is where the drop-in filter mount adapter is really helpful, as I can use a VND filter to achieve the perfect exposure. One way of bringing up the environment into the picture is to try long exposure shots. I like using the RF 1535 lens, as it has a wide angle that captures enough surroundings within the frame to complement the structure. Clouds streaks across the sky, or traffic movement draw light lines within the image. Altogether, it creates a painterly photo. As a previous user of the EOS 5D Mark III, the EOS R5 45 megapixels full-frame sensor spot more than twice the number of pixels and has a much higher dynamic range, giving great balance and tonality between highlights and shadows. It's a big improvement that helps me utilize my shots to its fullest potential without losing image quality. In black and white fine art architectural photography, negative space can be constructed with cropping and balanced with darker tones to create a minimalistic feel. I edit my images according to my mood and feel. Sometimes, my adjustment may even go up to 20 layers, just for the viewers to see my vision in the completed pictures. Follow your instinct, go with the flow. Even a minor adjustment will bring the picture to life. As a veteran in this genre, it's rewarding to see young photographers create beautiful photos. Being self-taught, here's my experience. If you are new to architecture photography, be patient with the process. Dream big, and one day, your hard work will be recognized.
Canon, delighting you always.